What's good, everyone? Hello and welcome into another reaction. If you're new here, I'm Kale, and up next in the view askew universe is Clerks 2 from 2006, coming a whole 12 years after the first one. And speaking of the first one, if you missed my reaction to it, definitely go click up here. I loved the first Clerks movie. I thought it was so much fun, so I'm really excited to check out this one because of how long it's been since the first one. I anticipate the same characters, but I also know that Rosario Dawson is in this one, so I'm very excited for that to see kind of what her dynamic is in this movie and story and with these characters. I think it's gonna be a good time. I'm going in excited and happy, and I just wanna thank you so much for taking the time out of your day to watch me watch this movie. And I'm really looking forward to talking with you about it in the comments. As always, if you prefer the watch along instead of this chopped up edited version, come on over to Patreon. Just bring your own copy of Clerks 2 and sync it up with me. And with that, let's get into it. Got to be in his head, right? Or is it just the CGI? Oh no, it's real. Okay, it's real. It's just the CGI. What is he doing?
Terrorists. I left the coffee pot on again, didn't I?
Oh.
Now where am I gonna bring chicks to fuck when my mom's home?
Oh, he works at Movies now? Movies, right? That's the name. So it's not Quick Stop anymore. We get the fast food experience in this movie. I kind of love that they still work together, though.
So, ready for your big last day?
I am.
When do you and your old lady head down to Florida?
Tomorrow morning.
Florida. Aww.
Can't believe they haven't done anything with it yet.
Lord did something with it. He smited that hellhole.
You mean to tell me you don't miss that place at all?
God, no. You?
A little bit. Oh, jeez. It's only $4? They are here so early.
You know, sometimes I wish I did a little more of my life instead of hanging out in front of places selling weed and shit. Like maybe be an animal doctor. Why not me?
Oh, I love his tank top. The Buddy Christ.
Holy shit. Our first customer since our triumphant return. That cool. Hold on.
I dig Jay's shorter hair.
How about a nickel bag, man?
Oh, 15 bucks, little man. Put that shit in my hand. Fucking Middletown cop pulls us over for suspicion of mischief. We were driving around with deployed airbag. The cops pull us over, they find 2 pounds of Jamaican lamb's wool. The judge gives us rehab instead. 6 months, sir. We got 6 months and 2 days on the wagon as a good friend of Bill W's.
Yeah, but if you're holding all the time, aren't you gonna be tempted to get high?
Oh, not with the power of Christ on my side, sir.
Oh my gosh.
The fuck kind of songbird Jesus freak dealers you bring me to?
I like them, man. They're funny.
Me too. What is he doing?
What are you writing over there anyway? Your memoirs?
I'm battling this jackass on his blog's message board on how he's got too much free time and no life.
Says the guy who's flaming him on his website.
It's this fucking wheelchair that's always preying on everyone's sympathies, writing these long diatribes about how he'll never walk again.
It sounds like some poor crippled guy pouring out his heart and feelings.
Oh, fuck him, man. Trying to guilt me into walking around more because he's all gimped out? What kind of mind fuck is that shit? So I've been getting into it with him, throwing it back in his stupid boy face about how I love this.
You fucking freak.
Ow. 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 My ears aren't stretched that big, but, no. I didn't like that.
Have you become so embittered that you now feel the need to attack the handicapped?
Apparently.
That guy's just in a wheelchair. It's not like he's Anne Frank or something.
Anne Frank?
Yeah. and Frank. Till the miracle worker showed up and knocked some smarts on the door.
You're talking about Helen Keller.
No, I'm not. I'm talking about Anne Frank. She was deaf, dumb, and blind.
No, she wasn't. Helen Keller was deaf, dumb, and blind.
She was not dumb. What does her shirt say? Mrs. Hit. Oh, hey, Ben.
It's not very hygienic. That's all I'm going to tell you.
The handlebar mustache, I can't.
Emma, are you like this because you have an unnaturally large clit?
You just had to tell him, didn't you?
It kind of came out one day.
He says it's so big it's almost like a little cock.
You wouldn't want to be with a girl with an oversized clit.
No, because the next stop is a guy with an undersized dick.
Bro, you guys are making out way too long.
There is no point in getting an apartment anymore. My mother has pretty much told us that she's gonna get us a house as a wedding gift.
They're giving us a house? Your dad's giving me one of his car washes to run? It just feels weird.
It just feels weird because you're so used to life shitting on you all the time.
What the fuck does that mean?
All I'm saying...
What's up? Just saw you guys talking, thought I'd come out here and join you.
God, it must be nice to have a job with so much downtime.
I was just gonna say, is this place not busy?
I was actually gonna ask you two to knock it off while I was out here.
I don't fucking understand why you can't be happy for your best friend. He finally found a woman who loves him.
Like you even register as a chick to me. Might as well be a dude.
Bro.
Girl, I don't think of you in any way. Oh, that was just wrong.
If you don't get the fuck out of here so that I can... Next, I'm gonna show you my pooter.
Why would you want to do something like that? All right, I'm leaving. Jesus.
I love you too.
I'm happy for Dante.
Dude, I'm pretty sure your old lady wants to get you and me together in a three-way.
Randall. Wow, this is a very cheery family. Oh my gosh, the moo when you open the door.
Well, at least you spelled cock right this time.
Why the fuck are you still getting rides from your mother?
You're not gonna bother me today, Randall. I'm in too good a mood.
Because your mom slipped you the tongue?
I just read online that there's gonna be a live-action Transformers movie. My online handle is Optimus Prime.
AKA, I'm a huge Transformers fan.
Best possible net handle and email address for when the movie comes out.
You're gonna be rolling in the pussy, man.
Don't be gross.
Leave Elias alone, Randall!
Don't look at his wee-wee.
This place feels so lax.
They could beat the pants off Ranger Danger any day.
I'll lose sleep wondering whether you're right about that or not.
Oh.
I thought you weren't even allowed to watch a lot of TV in your house because you're all Christian and shit.
Cars and trucks that turn into robots aren't really that blasphemous because my pastor says that machines can turn into other machines and it's not a slight against God.
And as much as God sent his only begotten son to die on the cross to redeem mankind and all we did to pay him back was make terrible fucking cartoons.
Because at Bible camp, we made this flow chart which proved or whatever that, okay, so
Bible camp.
Since God created...
I went to Bible camp once or twice. I was literally like 5 years old.
Let me help you out of your jam, Grandma.
Grandma, what was it like to be on the holiday side?
Late that night, I awoke from my sleep.
Oh gosh, this poor guy. Leave him alone.
Laughing insane!
Saw that coming. I cringed before it even happened.
Oh, what the fuck was that?
I saw Becky, so I waved.
Becky. You can wave at people through the windows.
It's called friendship.
She's your boss. You can't be friends with your boss.
A boss.
You spend an awful lot of time talking to her.
I spend an awful lot of time talking to you, too.
And I've always maintained you're harboring an unrequited homosexual crush on me.
We're just friends.
Jay. Why?
I knew it. You're fucking around with the boss. The best part of this job is all the barely legal pussy that comes in here. And they all look up to me because I've got a driver's license. It's awesome.
You're 33. You sure?
I hate that.
17-year-olds nowadays are crazy. They're up for anything. They even like it when you go ass to mouth. Bex, do you ever go ass to mouth?
You never go ass to mouth.
Not even once.
Not even ever.
You're both so repressed. All right, look. When you're done chowing down on the no-no parts of your lover, you kiss him, right? That's just like going ass to mouth.
Okay, I'm pretty sure you just compared a vagina to an asshole. Have you restocked all the napkin holders yet?
Let's change the subject. Randall's spicy in this movie.
All right, I'm gonna tell you this because we're friends, but sometimes, in the heat of the moment, it's forgivable to go ass to mouth.
I knew it.
I'm fucking bored, man. Boredom's the first step on the road to relapse.
Is this what I think it will be? I feel like there's a mirror right beside the camera. Because he's looking just to the left, or I guess his right.
Shit. I'm gonna miss you, Hicks.
Yeah, I'm gonna miss you too.
I still can't believe you're just gonna leave me alone in this place. With Randall Graves, of all people.
Move to Florida. You can work at the car wash with me.
As soon as my uncle's on his feet again, it's not like I'm gonna be staying here.
Hey, how's it doing?
Always nice to work for someone where you have this kind of rapport with each other. Makes the job tolerable.
But Hicks, we can sit here making small talk about your last day and what it is I'm going to do once you're gone. Or we can treat this like any other work day.
He paints her nails. Interesting. I don't want to make assumptions about what's to come yet.
One ring to rule them all.
Oh my gosh, I love onion rings.
You wonder why no chick will let you stick your cock in her, because you've accepted the fact that you'll never get a chick a long time ago.
Bro, be nice. Randall's not nice.
I know you're a huge fucking nerd of Potsy-like proportions, and no chicks dig nerds.
Yes, we do.
Especially nerds that are into Lord of the Rings.
Yes, we do.
Chicks dig Lord of the Rings, Randall.
We sure do.
The kind of chicks that are into swords and elves and shit.
We
and
sure
I
do.
Fuck them with the Torch of Gondor.
That's fine. That's okay. You don't have to, Randall.
Skinny calf and order of onion rings.
One ring to rule them all.
One ring to find them.
Oh, Jesus.
Yes, suit. 4 for return.
There's only one return, okay? And it ain't of the king, it's of the Jedi.
Oh, Star Wars geek.
You can like both.
Maybe we should start calling your friend Padme, because he loves Mannequin Skywalker so much. My shitty acting is ruining Saga.
Yeah, you're crazy, Jar Jar.
Right, I gotta remember when this movie came out, 2006. That would have been when people were still on this huge, like, prequel hate, right?
And here's the second movie.
The Lord of the Rings was a massive achievement that even the Academy recognized when they gave Peter Jackson the Best Directing Oscar, an award your little friend George Toy Boy Lucas has never.
Toy boy.
He would have ended the third one on the logical closure point, not the 25 endings that followed.
What's the logical closure point?
When fucking Frito wakes up from his little...
Frito?
And then right after the Sam Frodo suckfest, right before the credits roll, Sam fucking flat out bricks in Frodo's mouth.
I swear... Fuck you!
I made fun of Lord of the Rings so hard it made some super geek puke all over the counter. Where do we keep the mop and bucket so I can have Elias clean it up?
In the closet with the rest of the cleaning products.
He never cleans. Got it.
Why does it smell so weird in here?
Bye-bye.
Nail polish does have a pretty fucking weird smell.
You know he's not gonna make it here long once you're not here to protect him anymore, don't you?
Well, you're the one out there encouraging him, advocating ass to mouth.
Like you wouldn't do it if Emma told you to.
Christ, no.
Oh, I thought love knew no bounds.
No, oh, there's some bounds sometimes.
I don't know why I said that. I actually kind of like Emma.
So do I. I forgot. You're the cold-hearted ice princess that doesn't believe in marriage.
Yes, I do think that marriage goes against our primal nature.
To be loved?
To fuck as much as possible. Just propaganda to get us to marry, have kids, and keep the economy going. Marriage is just the keystone to economics.
You're such a sappy girl.
She's got a point.
In romantic love? No.
You don't believe in romantic love? Ugh, I will always believe.
There's only one person out there for me. Come on, you know how many people there are out there?
Yeah, I don't believe in the one person thing. Well,
based on your theory, there's someone out there better for me than Emma.
Oh no, I'm not touching that one.
Wait. It's a controversial conversation. Oh no, oh no.
You love what she represents.
Which is?
Or love the idea of her.
She's the girl who wouldn't give you the time of day back in high school. And years later, after she's played the field, she's finally gone with someone who looks...
Oh my God, you're gonna say fugly, aren't you?
Unconventional!
Nice backpedal.
Thank you.
What am I, some hideous fucking chud over here?
No!
No, you're a catch. Kinda. And Emma's a catch too. She'll make all your decisions for you. Which is lucky, because you're pretty terrible at making decisions.
So last day is all about you telling me what an ugly, indecisive loser I am.
I really like their chemistry, which I don't want to, because I don't want him to like cheat on Emma, but anyway, we'll see how it goes. These two are great together though.
Like, come down to Florida with me and I'll fuck your brains out and my daddy will give you a job. She's your golden ticket, dude.
So, what's that make you?
I'm just the girl who fucks ugly, indecisive losers in the kitchen once this place is closed.
Oh my God, young Rosario is fantastic. I haven't watched anything with her in it that's this, I don't want to say old because 2006 shouldn't feel that long ago. It's almost 20 years ago though. Anyway, she's fun.
Do you regret it?
Do you?
So they
I regret
did.
That it was on the prep station table.
They did.
Yeah, you regret it. You weren't the one who got mayo in your cooch.
Makes sense.
You're just lucky I'm not one of those monogamists like your girlfriend. Otherwise, I might try to make you stay in Jersey.
If anyone could do it, it'd be you.
Oh, boy.
That's my surprise?
No.
Goodbye, horses.
Wait. Silent Bob is looking at him. I literally had to do a double take on that. I was like, what is going on?
What's sexier than an elf princess's sword?
A donkey show?
What's that?
You ever see a chick give a mule a blowjob?
Oh, gosh!
If you spoil this, I'm gonna brain you.
What has happened to Randall in the last 12 years? I liked him way more in Clerks.
Kinky Kelly and the Sexy Stud. Straight from their dirty debut in Tijuana, Kelly's taking it on the road. This is an emergency. We gotta lock up Kinky Kelly for tonight so we can give Mr. Dante a memorable send-off.
Oh, no.
We should probably cross dicks, too.
The website in the background is so 2006. I love it. I miss 2006 internet.
Look, I know it's 3 months away, but it would mean so much to us if you could make the trip down.
I thought we were waiting till we got down there before we picked a date.
Oh, him is so cute. Him thinking again, huh?
It's very belittling.
Guess you gotta make their decisions for him sometimes.
We got a little triangle here.
What if you haven't ever seen pics of anything like that?
Well, then you must be as blind as Anne Frank, because what's the point in having an internet connection if you're not using it to look at weird, fucked up pictures of dirty sex you'll never have yourself?
I love that he didn't respond to that, just walked away.
You're a virgin, aren't you?
You know I have a girlfriend, Randall.
Have you and Myra had sex yet?
Well, that's just kind of personal, Randall.
You're talking to someone who's religious. The answer's most likely going to be no.
Well, not that it's any of your business, Randall, but she can't. Well, we can't because of Pillow Pants.
The fuck's Pillow Pants?
Pillow Pants is a little troll who lives in her pussy.
What?
Duh.
Why the music just kind of like eerie?
Every girl's parents put a pussy troll in them when the girls are young, keep them from having premarital sex.
Sure.
If I put my thing in her, Pillow Pants will bite it off. I gotta wait until Pillow Pants gets peed out of her body on her 21st birthday before we can have sex.
Have you and Myra even kissed yet?
We would have already if it wasn't for Lister Fiend.
Who's that?
Lister Fiend is her mouth troll, isn't it?
Women.
Oh, man.
I'll be right back.
Randall Graves. You work here too? Jesus, anyone else from our graduating class back there?
Oh my gosh.
You know, I'll bet dollars to donuts when you two aren't fighting about who shot first, Han or Greedo.
The popped collar, I can't.
You see, freshman year, the seniors would hunt us down and put us through what they called initiations. Lance here got the worst of it. The seniors yanked down his pants and shoved a pickle up his ass and made him walk 10 feet. The pickle fell out before he hit the 10-foot mark. He had to take a bite of it, reinsert it, and walk again.
No thanks.
What do I want? About a skinny calf with cheese and a Diet Coke.
I'll get your order.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Why? I would refuse.
You know what? Take mine. Something tells me I'm not gonna like it, am I?
I feel like Jason must have been filming My Name is Earl. I can't remember when that show started, what year it was, but...
But when I heard you guys were actually working here, it's kind of comforting to know that some things never change.
I'll admit it's nice to see Randall on the other side of this kind of shit. Oh, no. Oh, no.
You know, this tastes like piss and flies, don't it?
Aw, cute. Honestly, I feel like doing this would make anyone feel better if they're in a bad mood. It's impossible to not have fun doing this.
Man, that shit Lance said must have really bothered you.
Oh, fuck him. He's an asshole. He always was. At least I got a go-kart trip out of it.
Why do the go-karts help?
They just remind me of a better time in my life.
Yeah, childhood, maybe.
But sometimes I get the feeling the world kind of left us behind a long time ago.
Aww.
You can do something about that.
Yeah, life is what you make it, mostly.
You can get out of movies too. Completely change your situation in life.
What'd be the point? Besides, what do you give a shit? You're leaving.
Oh, man. I feel like Randall's got some deep-rooted stuff that he's dealing with, and his mask is his ridiculous humor.
I need to get some Mexican work in the head. It'd be pew.
They don't play around.
It made me lose my job. I could put a roof up in 30 seconds.
What the fuck is Coxton?
I don't know. That's some white freaky stuff. White boys get the white women to do everything.
Oh my gosh.
It's not a waste of time. It's all building towards something.
How about you build towards making some fucking fries?
They're coming!
I love that they're like involved in the conversation, kind of.
Randall! I'm sorry, he
didn't really just say what I think he said.
What?
I want my money back right now.
Baby, you can't taste racism.
What racism?
I'm gonna take the food, thank you very much.
It's a racial slur against black people.
Is
Randall!
Did Randall just call Mr. Dante?
Those are racial slurs.
I'm going to pretend like this conversation didn't happen.
I feel like I genuinely have to edit that whole thing out of the YouTube edit. Oh my gosh.
Despite the fact that your grandmother might have
used... These guys are like, we're getting the hell out of here.
Man, she was just an old timer. That's the way people talked back then. Didn't mean they were racist.
But my grandmother did refer to a broken beer bottle once as an... You know. Come to think of it, my grandmother was kind of a racist.
Yeah, no fucking shit.
I still don't think he should be considered a racial
That's
term.
Not your...
race. And even if it could be saved, you can't save it because you're not black!
Well, listen to you. You're the racist.
I am feeling like Dante right now.
It's cool, I'm taking it back.
Randall is absolutely unhinged. I need to rewatch Clerks. Girl, I don't blame. Oh, that's a cute picture. And this whole place is run by 4 people. Impressive. Or maybe they do have other coworkers and they just don't give a shit about them, which would suck.
I was thinking that maybe you were waiting for some friend to try and stop you from going through with the wedding by asking if you're even ready to go and get married.
Oh, girl.
I'm asking, are you scared about getting married?
Kinda.
I think it's normal. Even if you're like super duper in love with the person you're marrying, I think it's normal to be nervous and scared to get married because... It's a big commitment.
I don't know how to dance.
You're kidding.
I wish I was.
Same. I've never had formal dance lessons.
But this is one of the only times I'm ever going to meet most of Emma's extended family. And I'd like to be able to show some flair on the dance floor, you know? Like, maybe they'll see whatever it is that Emma sees in me.
I don't think they're going to see that on the dance floor, though.
Come on. Hey, 12-step!
Look up.
Lord?
Oh, my God.
Up here, jackass. You still got your boombox? Something danceable.
Up here?
I actually love that we're getting another roof scene, though. What song is this going to be? You can dance to this, though.
Yes! Okay.
Okay, this is better.
Just follow what it is what I'm doing, okay? Watch me, right?
Rosario is friggin' adorable, dude. I love her. Oh man, you can tell. He's got some feels in there. And she's got feels right back. The pigtails. Oh my gosh, we get a whole dance scene? No way. Where do these people come from?
I love you, Becky.
Whoa. Whoa.
I'm pregnant, Dante.
Whoa. What? Randall, you really just did that on your uniform?
I'm having second thoughts.
About your sexuality?
About going to Florida.
Yeah, right. Why now, all of a sudden?
Well, a lot just happened the last 5 minutes.
Becky's pregnant.
She is? So what, are you afraid you're gonna miss the baby shower?
I'm the father.
Holy shit, she got pregnant off the toilet seat you jerked off onto. I fucking knew it!
No, we had sex one night after work a few weeks ago. What?
Oh, a few weeks ago.
See, how the fuck do you always have, like, two good-looking girls who want you? You're the most hideous fucking chud.
Stop!
Just for me. Becky says she doesn't want anybody to know.
Then what'd you tell me for?
Look.
Jane Salabobber right there.
Can I talk to you for a minute?
Oh, yeah, sure. We were just...
May your first child be a masculine child.
Becky! Randall!
She was sweating me. It just came out.
Oh!
You fucking snitch.
Sorry, Randall. I'm sorry.
I feel so bad for him. So bad.
How the fuck could this day get any worse?
Well...
What the fuck are you doing, man? Follow her! You two have got to work this out. Follow her, talk to her for an
hour. I'm so glad Randall just realized. Yeah, really bad timing for this.
How long is it going to take you to set up?
Got to hook up the boombox, hang a few curtains and some lights.
The tattoo. Born to fuck.
An hour before the guest of honor gets back. So do I meet Kelly before the show or what?
Is it him?
Nah. Kelly likes privacy before showtime.
Okay, see, I thought that he was going to ask these guys to, like, leave. Why did I think Randall would do that? Oh, I love this song. She about... Jay would be so fun to dance with.
No, not again. Yeah, I have a fire at the movies on Memorial Parkway and Leonardo.
Oh, no. I don't think I'm ready for what I'm about to see.
Oh, my God. Is Elias hammered?
Yeah. Isn't it awesome? My man smoked two blondes full of skunk.
Oh, gosh.
Fuck pillow pants. Honk if you love her like pussy. Straight from TJ, I give you Kinky Kelly and the Sexiest Dude.
Naughty girls need love too.
The look on Dante's face.
Don't worry, chick's coming.
Randall, I'm not so sure.
Any second the chick's coming.
No, Randall. Oh my gosh, I feel like so much of this reaction I have to, like, mute, blur. nervous Ted at this one.
Randall, where the fuck's the chick?
Today, Randall learned that Kelly is a unisex name.
I thought that's the sexy stud.
I'm the sexy stud.
Okay.
Kelly can be a guy's name, too.
Hey, there's not going to be any chick.
Who the fuck's going to blow the donkey?
Well.
Oh, my God.
Becky.
And when is the fire department about to show up? They're not really fast.
And I can't look away. It's huge! Did you see the size of that cock?
I love you. And I think you love me too.
Of course. I mean, we're friends.
I think you love me as more than a friend.
But I don't believe in romantic love.
Maybe you should.
Do you really want to do this right now?
Well, I guess the show's over. I don't think so, sir.
Nope. Oh my God, why are we panning? No. Why are we panning up? No!
He's gonna jerk off, I'm gonna jerk off too.
Stop, Elias, don't. Don't. Boys, make some noise. Why?
All right, I do.
Do what?
Oh my God, this is so awkward.
I do love you.
Y'all, leave the building. First, leave the building. No! No. I mean, I'm happy for them.
What kind of sick fuck it's turn on watching a guy fuck a donkey?
I'm sorry, Jesus.
Hey, Emma. This just went even worse. Oh, she put so much work into it. I feel bad for her. I feel really bad for her. Dante should have done the right thing and called her first to have a very important conversation.
You're having a baby, right?
No, who said that?
Jay.
You fuck! Oh.
Quick, hit that two time and fuck with this!
Jay.
Hey, wanna go out sometime?
Jay!
Take him, fucking whore.
What a day everyone has had. Oh, here's the fire. Yeah, okay. Took you guys long enough, Jesus. I've not... This movie is ridiculous.
Jail cell design hasn't changed much in centuries, has it?
What do you think, Dante?
Dante is not in the mood.
I think I wanna kill you!
Off of
what
me!
Up, steel cage match!
You ruined my life!
Dante, you made choices.
A fucking donkey show?
It was your going
away
prison.
Okay, true. I do agree
sure
with you
was.
On that one.
I just never thought I'd be going away to prison.
Hey, boys, you guys will walk. I miss my donkey.
I finally get my shit together, and you somehow figured out a way to obliterate all that and reduce me to a convict.
I remember like 10 years ago, the night we went to Julie Dwyer's funeral, you were all like, I need to shit or get off the pot.
You said shit or get off the pot, not me.
Those mall rats, right? Or clerks. Clerks, they went to the funeral.
One semester we took criminology, for Christ's sakes. What the fuck are we training to be, Batman?
At least we were doing something instead of wasting our lives in some fucking convenience store.
You can badmouth Quick Stop all you want, but I miss that place. I look back on that period as the best time of my life.
Now I know you're fucking nuts.
And hang out with my best friend all day. Can you think of a better way to make a living? Yeah, maybe it's not what everyone does, but it was pretty fucking good.
I'm not in high school anymore. Shit, I'm not even in my 20s anymore. Well, if that's all you want out of life, man, then God bless. I'm gonna smooth things over with Emma, go to Florida, and start my Randall Graves free existence. And try to forget these last 33 years ever happened.
Write off your whole life? Forget your whole life up to this point?
So that's the way you see all this time we've spent together?
Aww.
It's weird, man.
Boy's
I
cracking.
Thought you were the only guy in the world who got me and had my back. I assumed you felt about me the same way I feel about you. Then all of a sudden, one day, you're like, I'm moving, bye. Do you know what that's been like for me?
Thanks, good point.
And you're not even throwing me over for a life that means something to you. It's just
this movie is crazy for giving us everything we just had at movies and then throwing us into this, which is like a super serious, like wholesome scene. With a really good conversation that's like relatable.
You think I want to start making friends at my age?
It's hard, I know, dude.
Christ.
I know.
Who would want me as their friend? I hate everyone and everything seems stupid to me.
Something you can change about yourself, though. You don't have to hate everyone.
I really wish you would have told me this when I first met you, that one day you were gonna bail on our friendship.
You don't know that.
I wouldn't even have bothered with your ass in the first place.
You never predict that, though.
Jesus, why don't you two just fucking get it over with already?
Jay, not helping.
Why can't you ever say something useful for a change?
Well, what the fuck you...
Come on, Bob. Please?
I got nothing.
Oh, no.
Jesus, if you had any sense whatsoever, you'd fucking stop trying to bray it up with the rest of the sheep and live your life the way it makes sense for you, you fucking ass.
What the fuck would the great Randall Graves do if he were half the master of his destiny that I'm supposed to be?
I'd buy the quick stop and reopen it myself.
Do it then.
That's what we should do.
Yeah, right. Who are we, Lance Dowds?
You could ask him for money. What do they say, 20 million or something?
We do.
What?
That's right.
You guys would be willing to lend us some of that money so we can reopen the stores?
Sure, on two conditions. One, we can hang out in front of the store anytime we want and you can't call the cops. And two, you have to blow each other. And we get to watch. All right, just the first condition.
Good.
I almost hate to say it, but it kind of makes sense.
Good idea.
You and me running our own business instead of working for some other asshole? It could be pretty fucking sweet, right?
Yeah, it really could. But I don't know, man. I was this close and starting a new life.
Can you guys cover your ears for a minute, please? You're my best friend. And I love you in a totally heterosexual way.
Yeah, right.
Guys.
Please, man, don't leave me.
Aww. This movie is a trip. A whiplash on, like, two opposite sides.
That'll be $5.79.
Aww. Please tell me that's at least a new ring, though, and not the one that Emma threw at her. Oh, she doesn't care, though, so it's fine. Aww.
One ring to rule them all.
There you go. I assure you we're reopen. I love it. Group hug? Just like old times. Boombox? Hell yeah.
Thanks.
Want a shoplift? Let us know. Thanks. Hell yes.
You know what?
What?
You're not even supposed to be here today.
Can you feel
it? It's like old times. I love it.
Feel what?
Today is the first day of the rest of our lives.
Fade to black and white. Oh my gosh. Hell yes. Is it the same woman too? Same actress? Actually, I think if I remember y'all correctly, in the first movie you told me it wasn't even an actress. It was like someone that Kevin knew and just like asked to bring in, I think. How do I review this movie? What am I supposed to say about what I just watched? Let me talk about what I liked, because I think that will be far easier to get through. I really loved Becky. I think Rosario was very adorable and super cute and was fun and delivered the lines really well. Becky was fun, really loved her. And because of that, I really enjoyed the relationship between Dante and Becky. I do think Dante was in the wrong to not talk to Emma first about anything. Like, he got Becky pregnant a few weeks prior. Well, they've clearly been ready to get married for quite some time at this point and had a planned move to Florida and everything. And Dante goes ahead and makes a choice. Did it work out from the mainland? Absolutely. And did I prefer Becky and Dante together over Dante and Emma? Absolutely. Dante and Emma, to me, just did not feel like a good match. Really, they just felt too different, whereas the chemistry between Becky and Dante was great. Really, really great. And I think that goes to show, and maybe that was the purpose of this, is that, like, because what? They said Emma was someone from high school that would never, like, give him the time of day, and then fast forward all this time later, and Emma's kind of like, hey, wanna, you know? Whereas, like, Becky and Dante have clearly, I mean, they've clearly known each other for a while and have this really great rapport and great relationship and great friendship, I should say, because that's the thing about friendships is, you know, sometimes and often in a lot of cases, you know, you're friends with someone first, there's no interest really, but then over time you kind of realize, like, hey, you're pretty cool and I would like more with you, thanks. So that was Dante and Becky to me, and I just think they had great chemistry, and I really loved the scenes together. The dancing scene I really loved. Did it kind of feel a little bit out of place overall? In a way, yes. Like, I wasn't expecting a full-on montage of this. I didn't expect the whole song to play and us to be sitting there, but they did write it in to kind of make it make a little sense, I guess, you know, bringing up the whole wedding thing and Dante admitting that he's nervous about dancing and worried about what her extended family will think. So, I mean, they wrote it in well, but it just it was just very unexpected, I guess, but I did enjoy it. And then everything at the end of the movie, like pretty much the last, I want to say, 15 minutes of the movie or so, pretty much from the time that they got arrested and put into jail. Everything from that point on was really great. I really, really enjoyed that Randall is such a complicated character. And I'm sure that people have maybe done like character analysis videos on him. I'll have to go look because I kind of want to watch them because I really loved Randall in the first movie. And in Clerks, I mean, there was a lot of moments in Clerks where I think I rolled my eyes and stuff too, but just in comparison, I mean, the writing was a lot better in the first Clerks, and I'll get to that in a second, just to compare to this one. But also Randall and Dante were a lot younger, right? They were in their very early 20s. People change over time as they get older. Randall, I don't know, to me, he feels like a character that is using his ridiculous humor and personality as, like, I mean, I mentioned this, but like a mask to bury and hide just like shit that he's dealing with inside that he never ever wants to come out. And you can tell how threatened he felt, I think, by Dante just up and leaving. The line that he said about, like, all those decades ago, if you had known that you were gonna do this, like, why didn't you tell me so I didn't have to bother? And I don't know. It's easy to say that, but it's so unrealistic. Like, people never plan to ditch friends or to break up with someone or whatever. Like, we literally just cannot predict the future. And I mean, that's why divorce is a thing, right? We all enter relationships and marriages and stuff thinking that it's going to be forever. Start friendships and stuff. But it's like, you don't know. You don't know. Life is unpredictable and things change. And sometimes friendships end, marriages, relationships, whatever. There's nothing that can really be done about it. But Randall was hurting. Randall was hurting in that moment. But I really like that in the end, they decided to buy the quick stop and fix it up and reopen it and start a business together. And I love that for them. In a way, it almost makes me think that maybe Emma was that for Dante in the same way that Randall's humor and stuff feels like a mask to me. Maybe Emma in a way was like, what am I getting at here? I know that Dante mentioned this as like, gotta do something with my life kind of thing. It sucks that it involved like a person that he committed to on a romantic relationship level, like marrying her kind of thing. But maybe that was it for him. Like, maybe he felt that she was the only way out, or the only way to have a shakeup in life, I guess. Either way, I'm glad that they came to the conclusion of leaving movies, starting a business together, but going back to their roots and going back to clearly the best time of their life. I also like that Becky and Dante are clearly making it work and staying together. Love that for them. I'm happy for it. Aside from those things, everything else about the movie, everything else about the movie felt painful to get through. And I'm sure that that showed here and there in my reaction. Oh gosh, yeah. There was just a lot of conversations that I could have done without. The whole Donkey Kelly scene, unnecessary, horrible. The racist terminology conversation, that I think felt the most out of place out of everything. Is it an important conversation to have? Absolutely. Gotta call people out, make sure they're not using terms they shouldn't be. It just felt very dragged on for no reason. I think out of everything that I felt was just so ridiculous and painful to get through, I do think my favorite out of it all was the at-length conversation about Lord of the Rings versus Star Wars versus Transformers, because it just reminds me that things have not really gotten better with that. I mean, I don't know how things were back then when it comes to that kind of stuff, but I do feel like over time, and especially now, like we're living in an age where the internet is just like ruthless. Like people are ruthless online about interests and stuff, and people are so quick to shit on others online about them liking things or disliking things or whatever the case is. But I just kept thinking of that during that whole scene. It's just like, you can like everything. You can like both. You don't have to pick one or the other. You can love Lord of the Rings and you can love Star Wars and you can love Transformers, and you don't have to pick one, and you don't have to shit on anybody for loving Star Wars more than Lord of the Rings or loving Lord of the Rings more than Transformers or whatever. Like, anyway, I feel like that conversation was definitely the best one out of everything that I could have done without. So for that reason, because there's so much of this movie that felt like a lot to get through, Clerks 2 is definitely at the bottom of my ranked list of the VSQ movies so far, but I'm still not put off from continuing. I do still want to get through the rest of the movies, and Clerks 3 came out either last year or maybe even this year. I definitely want to follow up with these characters. Well, I don't know if Rosario Dawson's back in it. I'd be surprised actually if she was, but Dante, Randall, for sure. I must watch Clerks 3, but before we get there, we have some other movies to get to, so stay tuned. Stay tuned, everyone. And with that, I am very curious to go to Letterboxd with this movie to see what some people have to say. I'm sure that there are very mixed reviews. I'm sure that there are people that love this movie. I'm sure that there's people that feel pretty similar to how I do, so let's go check it out. One star review. Nobody talks like this. 3-star review, an improvement on the first with a lot of fun and a lot of heart. Being honest, if the whole film didn't revolve around a donkey show, I would have enjoyed it a lot more. That I agree with. And finally, a 4-star review. I actually really enjoyed this, like maybe more than the first Clerks. It's cool that it's fine not to move on, to just stay where you want. That's refreshing in a film, to see that you don't have to better yourself or strive for something better. Everything is fine the way it is. I like that a lot. Jay and Silent Bob were amazing in this. How does Jason Mewes never age? I would also like to know. He did look the same in this movie as he did in the first Clerks, to be honest. But you know what? This person makes a really good point. I also appreciate that, actually, because not everybody can climb a corporate ladder. Not everybody can make crazy money. Like, that is quite literally impossible. It is nice to see a film focus on that. All right, and now it's that time of the video where I turn it to you and I ask you to leave your comments down below. Do you feel the same way that I do about this movie? Or are you someone who really, really loves this or really, really dislikes this? Let's talk about it. Let me know if you feel the same way about Rosario that I do and you absolutely love her in this movie. I feel like she is like the only reason I would rewatch this because I loved everything. Every scene, every line, she was great. Anyway, with that, if you're not yet subscribed, please click here to do so. And if you want to continue watching something else of mine, click on over here. Would recommend some more of USQ reactions if you've missed any so far. Until next time, guys, have a good one. Cheers.